Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, guys, wherever you are in this beautiful world, whenever you're watching this YouTube video. Welcome to the Bitcoin Family YouTube channel. Yes, recording in the dark. Look, I have a new apartment, moon, it's dark, but I need to do this so you have your videos in the morning in Europe, guys. So I'm going to record a short TA update again, so you wake up with a beautiful cup of coffee and some Bitcoin news. Let's quickly jump into some amazing charts. I have a link. Three or four beautiful charts set, ready for you to go. Let's jump. First chart. This is, of course, the 4-hour chart in Bybit. And let's see what the BamBam indicator told us. The BamBam indicator told us long. There was a candle closing down above the yellow stepping line. There was some yellowish and bluish still, and greenish was appearing, but there was still blue on the bottom, which is not like a very positive signal. Still, that long would have been break even at the moment, or maybe even going up, but it's not the perfect long. That is what you see here in this green blue area. The thing that we expected was a W. We didn't see the W. We are still going a little bit sideways. So if we delete that W that we expected and we zoom in a little bit, we can see we again are creating a W. This W again is here, like there, going up, coming there. So normally when you break out of this pattern, you go up like this. So that is something that I expect. And then again, we run into the resistance of 60K. That is a W on the 4-hour. We have a long flag. We have some green building. The blue is going away. The green line is coming on the top over there. So it's becoming a more positive long on the 4-hour. But still, we need to see the breakout above that 58K level, the neckline of that W. Okay, that is the 4-hour chart. That's BAM. And look over here. This is the day chart. I already talked about it in yesterday's video. This divergence that we can see on the chart, we have seen the downtrend in the price, the uptrend in the RSI. This mostly leads to an uptrend in the price. This candle over here, this is a day candle that's going to close in 18 hours. So it started green, it went up, and it's coming down again. So we have downward selling pressure, and we need to turn that into a beautiful bullish candle that's going to go up to the 60K level again. And then we maybe get an explosive move that we expect in the last week of November. Maybe indeed, because we can still fall all the way back to the 50K level. And yes, then I'm not freaking out. I'm still zooming out. I'm still believing that there can be a bounce from these levels as well. But for me, let's wait. Let's wait and see what this week will happen. And that is what we see on the week chart, because every time when we freak out, like over here, we had a 25% drop. After that, a 70% run. At the moment, we have a 20% drop. And we could again have a 40% run, and that would bring us to around the 80K level, guys. So that's how easy it is. And that yellow line is a 2017 line. That is how we moved in the daily chart in 2017. So if we look now to the period of this green area over here, after the dump, we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, almost 10 candles before we explosively moved up. So if we look now, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So it can, we only have like a sideways candle at the moment. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It can take till the 28th of November, then we have like 10 sideways days before we have that explosive growth. All possible. It's all speculation, guys. Bam, over here. Now, Bitcoin mining, that's a very good one in Kazakhstan. And they're going to use nuclear solutions for the Bitcoin mining. Kazakhstan is already one of the biggest miners, so they are going to be even bigger. Also very positive news, Celsius. They are expanding the funding round with 750 million, tipping 7 billion to 10 billion valuation in 2022. That is huge. Use that one for staking, for example. Do we have other charts, Didi? Yes, we have some other charts. We have amazing charts that are over here. Bam. Oh my God, that was just perfectly. Perfectly timed. No, I didn't drink yet. I just had a long trip with the airplane and everything, and the travel and the bus and the taxi. So yes, I am a little bit tired, but making this beautiful video, guys. What do we see over here? This is the SOPR on the hourly chart at the seven daily moving average. The thing that we need to notice on this chart is this. The yellow line just crossed the one level again. We went from down below the one level to above the one level. Now, if we look back in history, when we saw that before, what happened then? Here, the last time we went from down below the one level to above the one level, we went all the way up to there, and then that took a week or two before the price was following up that yellow line. So the yellow line moved first, the price then started to move after that. So this is a very bullish indication that the yellow line can start to move and the price will follow up after. Do we have more charts? Yes, one bam, more amazing chart over here, guys. This one is really nice as well, comparing a few periods, a few bull runs, let's say like that, and the 2013, my shit, my face is really small, but yeah, it's bad quality, so it doesn't matter. 2013, we went a little bit sideways around that 1.618 level. Do you see this? In the RSI, we were then topping to this top line, with that dotted line, we want to break that. In 2017, at that 1.618 level, again, we did the same. We went sideways a little bit, you know, we tried to break it, we pulled back, we came up, and then we broke it, and then we had that last part of the run. Also here, we're around that dotted line. Now, 2021, we are fighting that 1.618 level. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4 candles, just like 2017, just like 2013, and we have the RSI now going down, so that one should be starting to crawl up to that dotted line. And that would then be the moment that we break the 1.618 level, all the way up maybe to that level over there. But that's a very high level for this year, I think, 240K. I think we need to be very happy if we reach $130,000 before the end of this year. Now, that was bam, enough information for today with my beautiful Pink Floyd beautiful shirt. If you know the name of the shirt, the back of the shirt, it's the dark side of the moon. Where's the moon? There's the moon. Guys, I hope you really enjoyed the video. If you did enjoy the video, give the video a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and leave a comment. What do you think about the charts? What do you think about the news? What do you think about my beautiful Pink Floyd t-shirt and the moon over there? Over there. And yes, I will continue to make this video in the evening as much as possible so that you have them in the morning. But I will also try to make some beautiful daily videos again with an amazing view of the sea that is now down behind me. You can see the glinting of the moon a little bit there. That's the sea. Yeah, beautiful. Now, thanks for watching and see you tomorrow again. Bam!